Hello dear students, let us move to last bit of microbes in human welfare. And in this video I am going to explain about microbes as biofertilizers. In the previous video I explained about microbes as biocontrol agents, where the plant diseases and the pests can be controlled by using biological agents such as bacteria, fungi and some insects. The ladybird and dragonflies can be used to control aphids and mosquitoes. Bacillus thuringiensis, it is a bacterium. Genes of Bacillus thuringiensis are used to control the larvae of the insects. Baculoviruses are used to control the insects and other arthropods. That is why they are considered as a narrow spectrum insecticide. Apart from that, Trichoderma species, wherever it is present in the soil, that soil or the plant in association with this Trichoderma, it makes the or it provides the protection to the plants against the pathogens. So these are the microbes which can be used as biocontrol agent instead of making use of chemical fertilizers and insecticides. So in the last bit of the chapter, you are going to study about microbes as biofertilizers. In the beginning of the topic only, I told you ಈ ಚಾಪ್ಟರ್ ಒಳಗೆ ಯೂಸ್ಫುಲ್ ಆಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೈಕ್ರೋಬ್ಸನ್ನು ಮಾತ್ರ ಸ್ಟಡಿ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ. ಸೊ ವಾಟ್ ಆರ್ ದೋಸ್ ಯೂಸ್ಫುಲ್ ಆಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟ್ಸ್? ಮೈಕ್ರೋಬ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಹೌಸ್ ಹೋಲ್ಡ್ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್, ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಸ್ಟಡೀಡ್. ಮೈಕ್ರೋಬ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಇಂಡಸ್ಟ್ರಿಯಲ್ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ಸ್, ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಸ್ಟಡೀಡ್. ಮೈಕ್ರೋಬ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಸಮ್ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಕ್ ಆ್ಯಸಿಡ್ಸ್, ಮೈಕ್ರೋಬ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಸೀವೇಜ್ ಟ್ರೀಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್, microbes to get the bioactive molecules and enzymes, microbes as biocontrol agent, and finally microbes as biofertilizers. Biofertilizers are the organisms that enrich the nutrient quality of the soil. Again, as a fertilizer, generally we make use of chemical fertilizers. ನಾವು ಈ ಜೈವಿಕ ಗೊಬ್ಬರವನ್ನು ಬಳಸೋದಕ್ಕಿಂತ ಹೆಚ್ಚು ರಾಸಾಯನಿಕ ಗೊಬ್ಬರದ ಮೇಲೇ ಡಿಪೆಂಡ್ ಆಗಿವಿ, ಬಯೋ ಫರ್ಟಿಲೈಸರ್. ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ ಫರ್ಟಿಲೈಸರ್ಗಳನ್ನು ನಾವು ಎಲ್ಲೆಲ್ಲಿ ಎಸೆನ್ಷಿಯಲ್ ಅಂತ ಬಳಸ್ತೀವಿ, ಇನ್ಸ್ಟೆಡ್ ಆಫ್ ದಟ್ ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ ಫರ್ಟಿಲೈಸರ್, ಇಫ್ ವಿ ಮೇಕ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಸಮ್ ಬಯಾಲಾಜಿಕಲ್ ಎಂಟಿಟೀಸ್, ಸಮ್ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ಸ್ which have the ability to enrich the nutrient quality of soil. ಮಣ್ಣಿನ ಫಲವತ್ತತೆನ ಹೆಚ್ಚು ಮಾಡುವಂಥ ಕೆಲವು ಮೈಕ್ರೋ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ಸು ಅವ. ಈ ಮೈಕ್ರೋ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ಗಳನ್ನು ಬಳಸೋದ್ರಿಂದ, ಇವನ್ ವಿದೌಟ್ ಮೇಕಿಂಗ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಎನಿ ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ ಫರ್ಟಿಲೈಸರ್, ದ ನ್ಯೂಟ್ರಿಯಂಟ್ ಕ್ವಾಲಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ದ ಸಾಯಿಲ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ಡ್. ಅಂಥ ಮೈಕ್ರೋ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ಗಳಿಗೆ ಏನಂತ ಕರೀತಾರೆ? ಬಯೋ ಫರ್ಟಿಲೈಸರ್ಸ್. ಅಂದರೆ ಟೋಟಲಿ ದೇರ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ನೋ ಯೂಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಎನಿ ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ ಫರ್ಟಿಲೈಸರ್. ಕೇವಲ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ಗಳನ್ನು ಬಳಸಿಕೊಂಡು, ಯಾವುದೋ ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ಗಳನ್ನು ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡಲಾರ್ದೇನೂ ಸಾಯಿಲ್ ಫರ್ಟಿಲಿಟಿನ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಮಾಡಬಹುದು. ಸಚ್ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಬಯೋ ಫರ್ಟಿಲೈಸರ್ಸ್. ದ ಮೇನ್ ಸೋರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಬಯೋ ಫರ್ಟಿಲೈಸರ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ಟೀರಿಯಾ, ಫಂಗೈ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸೈನೋ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ಟೀರಿಯಾ. Give example for the microbes which can be used as biofertilizer, athava which are used as biofertilizer. The answer is bacteria, fungi and cyanobacteria. So bacteria are capable of fixing the atmospheric nitrogen. Like that, cyanobacteria are also able to fix the atmospheric nitrogen. Then fungi are able to fix the phosphorus, they are able to absorb the phosphorus. These two things that you need to remember very clearly. Bacteria mattu cyanobacteria both of them are able to fix the atmospheric nitrogen. But wherever the fungi is present in the soil, it is able to absorb the phosphorus. Mannolagiddantha phosphorus anna absorb maadkotade yavudu fungi. Then bacteria in martava, they are able to fix the atmospheric nitrogen. Then coming to the detailed examples with respect to bacteria, cyanobacteria and fungi. In what way they are fixing the atmospheric nitrogen? Whether in the free living form or in symbiotic association, how they are fixing the atmospheric nitrogen? So with that respect, here is the first point. Root nodules of legumes. Leguminosae anodu vandu family. Family valaga baro hanta plants the root galige ithara gant agirthava. Ee gant galige nodules anta karitara. They are developed on the root of leguminous plants and they are called nodules. And what is the help of this nodule or why they are formed? Oh, yak produce agava and idrind adu ken help aagthada? So here is the answer. The nodules on the roots of leguminous plants formed by symbiotic association of rhizobium. Then question is, what is this rhizobium? Rhizobium is a bacterium and this is fixing atmospheric nitrogen, but in the symbiotic association. That's what in the beginning I told. Some bacteria can fix the atmospheric nitrogen only in the symbiotic association. Andre bere idra jothege mutual agi beneficial association olagiddaga matra kelavandu bacteria atmospheric nitrogen anna fix martava. And some bacteria can fix the atmospheric nitrogen in a free living condition. Bere yava plant adu jothegu adu serkolardene free agi idrunu koda adu nitrogen anna fix martada. So nodules are formed as a result of symbiotic association between roots of the leguminous plants along with the bacterium called rhizobium. And in nodule valagi yenu accumulate agirthada athwa yen reside agirthada, which is present in the nodule. Inside the nodule the rhizobium bacteria is present and this is fixing the atmospheric nitrogen. Then what is the mutual benefit here? The plant root has provided the shelter, irak jaga, protection and food to the rhizobium. Every basic requirement is getting from the plant and rhizobium is benefited. Then internal rhizobium en madlikattada? Rhizobium provides the atmospheric nitrogen to the plant and it is used by the plant as nutrient. Neevu yavude chemical fertilizer the pack anna observe madidre alle mooru element gala hesaranna mention madirtara. NPK, N for nitrogen, P for phosphorus, K for potassium. So NPK, they are very important essential nutrients for the growth and development of a plant body. So rhizobium is getting every basic requirement from the plant and in turn the rhizobium provides nitrogen to the plant and which is used as a nutrient by the plant. So this is the first example where the rhizobium is fixing atmospheric nitrogen in symbiotic association with the roots of leguminous plants. So this is the first example. Then bacteria which fixes the atmospheric nitrogen in symbiotic association, now we have the answer. It is rhizobium. Then question is, which bacteria can fix the atmospheric nitrogen in the free living form? Free living form olagi yavu fix maartava? Answer is the azoospirillum. This is the image and another is azotobacter. Azoospirillum and azotobacter are the free living bacteria which are able to fix the atmospheric nitrogen in the free living condition. Even though they are fixing the atmospheric nitrogen in the free living condition, but they are able to enrich the nutrient content of the soil. They increase the nutritional quality of the soil. They make the soil enriched with the nitrogen. So free living bacteria which are fixing the atmospheric nitrogen are Azospirillum and Azotobacter. So both of them are fixing atmospheric nitrogen in the free living form. These are the three examples that you need to remember compulsorily. Rhizobium fixes the atmospheric nitrogen in the symbiotic association with the roots of leguminous plants, whereas Azospirillum and Azotobacter are fixing the atmospheric nitrogen only in the free living condition. So this is about bacteria as biofertilizer. And soil the yava content na bacteria increase maadutada anta kelidre, answer is nitrogen. Then moving to next question, next part. Mycorrhiza. In the previous video only I explained the meaning of mycorrhiza. Mycos means fungus and rhiza means hair like structure. So which one is the hair like structure in the plant body? Only the roots are hair like structures. Mycorrhiza, again this is also symbiotic association of fungi with the plants. It is called mycorrhiza and the example is glomus. Glomus, it is a plant in which the roots are associated with the fungi. Glomus the roots so fungi jotege associate agirthava. Yavaga fungi plant the root gala jotege, especially higher plants and the angiospermic roots gala jotege symbiotic association in the madkotada, adakken anta karitara mycorrhiza anta karitara. Then question is, what is the benefit of this association? If any plant, it shows the symbiotic association with the bacteria, it is getting nitrogen as the nutrient. That nitrogen sikthada. But fungi jothege symbiotic association anna maadkondre, what is its benefit? In symbiotic association with the fungi absorbs phosphorus from the soil. Mannolagirohanta phosphorus na e fungi absorb markotada, and phosphorus is also a major nutrient which is required for growth and development. Then question is, soil olaga phosphorus ellinda bantu? The soil is product of rock weathering. Weathering of the rock means kallina saveta. Yavaga kallu samudu saudu powder bartade, that powder is nothing but soil. So rock is actually the source of phosphorus. Kallu olage phosphorus source sikka patte irtada. Yavaga kallina saveta agi mannu bartada, that soil also contains the phosphorus. Then coming to the additional effect. Of course, mycorrhizal association provides the phosphorus. Phosphorus is absorbed from the soil and passes into the plant. Okay. Then second one is, it gives resistance to root-borne pathogens and tolerance to salinity and drought. Another very, very important beneficial aspect of mycorrhiza. This is the image showing mycorrhiza with the root of plant. Phosphorus anna absorb maadkondu plant ge kodutada, one point. But innu one important point andre, here it gives resistance to root borne pathogens and tolerance to salinity and drought. Andra manninolaga lavana amsha uppina amsha jaasti aadrunu kuda plant haalagade iro tara yavdu help maadtada mycorrhiza. What is its first benefit? It absorbs the phosphorus from soil. Mannolagiro hanta phosphorus na absorb madkondo plantige supply madtada. And plantige bere yavudu root borne pathogen dinda infection agade irothara idu help madtada. Then question is why? Yaake pathogenu e mycorrhiza idd kadege baralla? Because wherever the fungi is present, whether it is free living or it is in association with plant part, the fungi are secreting some chemicals, and those chemicals are called antibiotics. You already idanna study madiri. Fungi yelle irli adrinda kelavu chemical galu secrete age aagtirtava. And aa chemical lo bere pathogen, other disease causing organism root ge eno damage na cause maadade iro thara help maadtada. Salinity ge tolerance bartada, drought, unavailability of the water. Yaake fungus plant body is mycelium. ಈ ಫಂಗೈದು ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ ಬಾಡಿಗೆ ಮೈಸೀಲಿಯಂ ಅಂತ ಕರೀತಾರೆ. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಮೈಸೀಲಿಯಂ ಹಿಯರ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸಿ ಇಟ್ ಶೋಸ್ ಮೆನಿ ಹೈಫೆ. ಹೈಫೆ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಇಂಡಿವಿಜುವಲ್ ಥ್ರೆಡ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಮೈಸೀಲಿಯಂ. ಈ ಮೈಸೀಲಿಯಮ್ಮು ಮಾಯಿಶ್ಚರ್ನ ಅಬ್ಸಾರ್ಬ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೋತದೆ, ತೇವಾಂಶನ ಅಬ್ಸಾರ್ಬ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೋತದೆ. ಆ ಮಾಯಿಶ್ಚರ್ ಕಂಟೆಂಟ್ ಅಬ್ಸಾರ್ಬ್ ಆಗೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಡ್ರಾಟ್ ಅಂದರೆ ಅನ್ಅವೈಲೆಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ವಾಟರ್, ತೀರಾ ವಾಟರ್ ಸ್ಕೇರ್ಸಿಟಿ ಇದ್ದಾಗಲೂ ಕೂಡ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟು ಹಾಳಾಗದೆ ಇರೋ ಥರ ಯಾವುದು ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ ಮಾಡ್ತದೆ? ಮೈಕೋರಹಿಸ. ದೆನ್ ಇಟ್ ಗಿವ್ಸ್ ಓವರಾಲ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ ಗ್ರೋತ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಡೆವಲಪ್ಮೆಂಟ್. ಒಂದೇ ಒಂದು ಸೆಂಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಒಳಗೆ ಕನ್ಕ್ಲೂಡ್ ಮಾಡೋದಾದರೆ, ಯಾವ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟದ ಜೊತೆಗೆ ಫಂಗೈ ಸಿಂಬಯೋಟಿಕ್ ಅಸೋಸಿಯೇಷನ್ನನ್ನು ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡಿರ್ತದೆ, ಆ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟದ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ಗ್ರೋತ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಡೆವಲಪ್ಮೆಂಟಿಗೆ ಮೈಕೋರಹಿಸ ಈಸ್ helping. So this is about the benefits of mycorrhiza. What are the benefits the plant is getting in mycorrhizal association, and fungi as a symbiont, what are the functions performed by it in the mycorrhizal association? So this is the explanation. Then last bit of the chapter, one more biofertilizer is cyanobacteria, commonly known as blue green algae. The very much advanced members of kingdom Monera, they contain the chlorophyll which is similar to that of the algae. That is why the common term is blue green algae. They are autotrophic microbes because due to the presence of chlorophyll they can synthesize their own food. It is autotrophic process, able to synthesize its own food. So these are autotrophic microbes. They also fix the atmospheric nitrogen. Cyanobacteria are able to fix the atmospheric nitrogen. What is the reason? I will explain later. Give example for the cyanobacteria: Anabena, Nostoc, Oscillatoria are the different examples of the cyanobacteria. In paddy field, bhattada gadde, in the paddy field, cyanobacteria serve as biofertilizer. It adds organic matter to the soil and increases soil fertility. ಈ ಭತ್ತದ ಗದ್ದೆ ಒಳಗೆ ಅಕ್ಕಿ ಬೆಳೆಯುವಂಥ ಜಾಗದೊಳಗೆ ಈ ಸೈನೋಬ್ಯಾಕ್ಟೀರಿಯಾನ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಅದು ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಕ್ ಮ್ಯಾಟರ್, ಅದನ್ನು ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಕ್ ಮ್ಯಾಟರನ್ನು ಸಾಯಿಲಿಗೆ ಆ್ಯಡ್ ಮಾಡ್ತದೆ, ಆ್ಯಸ್ ವೆಲ್ ಆ್ಯಸ್ ಸಾಯಿಲ್ದ ಫರ್ಟಿಲಿಟಿನ ಅದು ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತದೆ. ಸೊ ಹಂಗಾಗಿ ಇನ್ ದ ಪ್ಯಾಡಿ ಫೀಲ್ಡ್ ಜನರಲಿ the cyanobacteria are used. So like bacteria, cyanobacteria are also capable of fixing the atmospheric nitrogen. Atmospheric nitrogen na cyanobacteria kuda fix madtave, because they contain a specialized modified cell called heterocyst. Here it is anabena, this is nostoc, and this is oscillatoria. Svalpa cell shape na neevu observe maadbeku. It is different in anabena and nostoc. Here and there nimge illi kelavu structure galu ee tara round kanaslikattava. They are nothing but heterocyst. Ee heterocyst yen maadtada? This heterocyst is capable of fixing the atmospheric nitrogen. Due to the presence of heterocyst, the cyanobacteria are able to fix the atmospheric nitrogen. So this is about the microbes as a biofertilizer. Bacteria and cyanobacteria are fixing the atmospheric nitrogen either in the free living condition or in the symbiotic association. And this anabena, one point I would like to inform here, this is found in association with azolla. Azolla antandre idakka water fern anta karitara. ಈ ಮಾಸ್ಕಿಟೋ ಫರ್ನ್ ಮಾಸ್ಕಿಟೋ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ ಅಂತಾನೂ ಕರೀತಾರೆ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ. ಆ ಅಝೋಲಾದ ಜೊತೆಗೆ ಇದು ಸೇರ್ಕೊಂಡಿರ್ತದೆ. ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ಇವನ್ ಅಝೋಲಾ ಈಸ್ ಅಲೌಡ್ ಟು ಗ್ರೋ ಇನ್ ದ ರೈಸ್ ಫೀಲ್ಡ್. ಅಕ್ಕಿ ಬೆಳೆಯೋಲ್ಲೇ ಸಸಿನ ನೀರೊಳಗೆ ಹಾಕಿದ ಮೇಲೆ ನೀರು ಕಟ್ಟುತ್ತಾರೆ, ಅಂದರೆ ನೀರನ್ನು ನಿಲ್ಲಿಸ್ತಾರಲ್ಲೇ ಅದು ಸುತ್ತರದೆಲ್ಲ, ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಫೆನಿಸಿಂಗ್ ಥರ ಮಾಡಿ ಅಂದರೆ ಈ ಒಡ್ಡಗಳನ್ನು ಕಟ್ಟಿ ನೀರು ಹರಿಲಾರ್ದಂಗೆ ನೋಡಿಕೊಂಡು ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನೀರು ನಿಲ್ಲಿಸ್ತಾರೆ. ಅಂಥ ಕಡೆಗೆ ಈ ಅಝೋಲಾ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಅನಾಬೆನಾ, ಅಝೋಲಾದ ಬಾಡಿ ಜೊತೆಗೆ ಅನಾಬೆನಾ ಈಸ್ ಫೌಂಡ್ ಸಿಂಬಯೋಟಿಕ್ ಅಸೋಸಿಯೇಷನ್. ಅನಾಬೆನಾ ಈಸ್ ಫಿಕ್ಸಿಂಗ್ ದ ಅಟ್ಮಾಸ್ಫೆರಿಕ್ ನೈಟ್ರೋಜನ್. ಸೊ ಹಂಗಾಗಿ ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಮಚ್ ಫ್ರೀಕ್ವೆಂಟ್ಲಿ ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ದ ರೈಸ್ ಫೀಲ್ಡ್. ಆ ಪ್ಯಾಡಿ ಫೀಲ್ಡ್ ಅಂತ ಬಳಸಿದೆ, ಹಿಯರ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಟೆಲಿಂಗ್ ರೈಸ್ ಫೀಲ್ಡ್. ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ಕಾರಣ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಫಿಕ್ಸಿಂಗ್ ದ ಅಟ್ಮಾಸ್ಫೆರಿಕ್ ನೈಟ್ರೋಜನ್. ಫಾಸ್ಫರಸ್ ಎಲ್ಲಿರ್ತದೆ ಅಲ್ಲೇ, ಸಾರಿ ಫಂಗೈ ಎಲ್ಲಿರ್ತದಲ್ಲೇ ಫಾಸ್ಫರಸ್ ಫಿಕ್ಸ್ ಆಗ್ತದೆ. ರೂಟ್ ಬಾರ್ನ್ ರೂಟಿಗೆ ಬೇರೆ ಪ್ಯಾಥೋಜನ್ಗಳಿಂದ ಇನ್ಫೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಗಲ್ಲ. ಸಾಲ್ಟ್ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಬರ್ತದೆ, ಡ್ರಾಟ್ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಬರ್ತದೆ, ಟಾಲರೆನ್ಸ್ ಕೆಪಾಸಿಟಿ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಆಗ್ತದೆ. ಸೊ ಓವರಾಲ್ ಗ್ರೋತ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ ಆಕರ್ ಇನ್ ಅಸೋಸಿಯೇಷನ್ ವಿತ್ ದ ಫಂಗೈ. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸಮ್ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ಟೀರಿಯಾ ಆರ್ ಫಿಕ್ಸಿಂಗ್ ದ ನೈಟ್ರೋಜನ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಫ್ರೀ ಲಿವಿಂಗ್ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್. ದೇ ಆರ್ ಅಝೋಸ್ಪೈರಿಲಮ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಅಝಟೋ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ಟರ್. ಸೊ ವಾಚ್ ದ ವೀಡಿಯೋಸ್ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ಲಿ, ಅದರ್ವೈಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮೆಟಿಕ್ ಟು ಯು. And go through the completed topics again and again so that it is very easy to remember the subject as well as you can write the answers more clearly. Hope you will do the things, and I think, I hope it is clear for you. Thank you.